Today we are going to talk about one of the most wonderful compositions, where you can see how smartly the symmetry is used. But first, take a look at other pictures. Let's draw a circle, and then another one, but its radius should be 2 times smaller. Mark a point on it. Here's a smaller circle rotating inside the bigger one without slippage. What do you think is a trajectory followed by this point? The point moves along the diameter of the larger circle. Now it's time to make it a little bit harder. Draw a circle that is 4 times smaller than the first one. What is its trajectory followed by the point in this case? This curve is called the Astroid. The name was not chosen by chance, because problems like this often occur in celestial mechanics. It's fascinating to look at all the circles at once. Turns out the diameter of the middle circle covers the figure bounded by the Astroid. That means it not only every time touches the curve, but also its endpoints, as we have already figured out, move exactly along the axis. Persian mathematicians knew this theorem a long time ago, in the 30th century, and hundreds of years later it served as a prerequisite for the creation of the heliocentric system. And here's a more commonly known property. Have a look at this triangle. Let's mark a point on its circumscribed circle and draw perpendiculars on 2 sides and the extension on the third one. What can we say about these highlighted points, feet of the perpendiculars? All of them lie in the same line. It was proved by Scottish mathematician William Wallace. That's why the theorem is called the Simson line. It's time for something unusual. Let's draw another triangle. The basis of the heights, as you remember, formed the orthotriangle. Now look closer. We need to inscribe circles exactly as in the picture. Their centers are the first 3 vertices. The inscribed circle of the initial triangle touches its sides at 3 new vertices. That is how we got hexagon. Do you notice anything particularly interesting about it? All sides are equal. Looking at the picture, you might feel that the opposite sides are parallel, and at the same time they are perpendicular to one of the sides of the initial triangle. If someone can prove it in the comments below, we can consider this is true. Finally, promised composition. 3 points are marked on the sides of the triangle. They are the vertices of a new triangle. You can move them how you want. The question is where they should be located, if you want the perimeter of the highlighted triangle to be minimal. Those who want to answer this question can pause, and as for us, we are about to dive into the solution. So, let's try to reflect point N over lines AB and BC. Then, segments NK and 1K are equal, so as NL and 2L. Think about what does this construction show us. In fact, the perimeter of the triangle equals the length of the polyline N1K LN2. And we know that the sum of the lengths of the links is greater than or equal to the length of the segment that connects the endpoints of the polyline. Now it would be great if we at least find the minimum length of N1 and 2. Think about this highlighted triangle. Its angle at vertex B is fixed, because it's 2 times larger than angle ABC of the triangle also named ABC. Turns out that the shorter sides being 1 and being 2, the smaller the length of the third side. Who knows under what condition the minimum can be achieved? Look, all 3 of highlighted segments due to the symmetry are equal. It means that the smaller the length of BN, the shorter the segment N1 and 2. But when BN is at its minimum? Only when it is a height. We proved that the perimeter of the triangle is never smaller than n1 and 2, and n1 and 2 is minimal when n is the base of the height bn. Is this minimum achieved? Yes, the length of the polyline coincides with the length of the segment n1 and 2 if we place points k and l right here. This result can be further clarified. In fact, we show that the inscribed triangle with the minimal perimeter is the only one. If we use a similar approach for points k and l, they will also be the basis of the heights. It means that the ortho triangle will have the smallest perimeter. If you can't figure this out, write questions in the comment section below. Think critically, do math, take care!